This is Bonnie from Comfort and Joy ASMR. Today I've decided to come to you inside of my car because my husband's watching football, my dogs are barking, my daughter is playing. We went to church this morning, we're getting ready to go to church again this evening, and I just didn't have the right situation in my home to record a video and make it ASMR for you all. But I still wanted to come to you today to give you the tools that you need to serve God this week, to stand against the enemy, to hide God's word in your heart, to show love to others, and to fulfill God's purpose for your life. So today I've got many of my favorite scriptures to share with you. So before we get started, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I love you so much, and I thank you so much, God, for your word. Your word is a double-edged sword that we have as a tool every day to fight against the enemy and to walk in your ways and walk in your paths and stand under your protection. And I love you, Lord, and I thank you for your word. I thank you so much for your word. It is a powerful tool. It is the sword of the Spirit. And I thank you for these viewers. Many blessings on every one of these viewers, Lord God, that they would know who they are in Christ Jesus, that they would know that they are loved by you, and that they would stand firm against the enemy and use these scriptures, Lord God, as a powerful weapon. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your death and resurrection, and I pray that you help me, Lord God. Help me, Lord God, to deliver this word to the exact right person that you intend to give it to, and that you would be glorified, and not me, Lord God. All glory to God. And I pray, Lord, that you help me, that I would speak smoothly, and that ears would be opened, hearts would be opened to receive your message, that many would come to Christ. Thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity. I love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. The first one I have for you is Psalm 119:11. Psalm 119:11 says, I have hidden your word in my heart that I might not sin against you. And that tells me that memorizing scripture is an important way to keep myself from sinning. The second one teaches me why I need to memorize scripture and why I need to say scripture out loud. I love this one. It has taught me so much. It's 2 Timothy 3:16 through 17. It says, all scripture is God breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness, so that the servant of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. I love this one. It tells me that all scripture, every scripture in the Bible, number one, is God breathed. It is written by God. Number two, every scripture in the Bible can be used to teach someone. Every scripture in the Bible can be used to rebuke the enemy. Every scripture in the Bible can be used to correct us or correct others if you're in a teaching situation. Every scripture in the Bible can be used to train God's servants in righteousness. I love it. And every scripture even means this one. The shortest scripture in the Bible is only two words. Anyone can learn it. Anyone can hide the scripture in their heart that they might not sin against God. And the scripture is also God-breathed and useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness. And it's John 11:35, and it simply says, Jesus wept. When the enemy is coming up against you, just proclaim the scripture out loud. John 11:35, Jesus wept. And you know what? If you can't remember that it's John 11:35, don't worry about it. Jesus wept. Scream it at the top of your lungs if you have to. When the enemy comes against you, fight him with the sword of the Spirit. Jesus wept. Here's another one. This is beautiful. It's Psalm 145:9. The Lord is good to all. He has compassion on all he has made. I love that because there's so many times in this world where we get mad at God or others blame God for the fall. That's what it is. I mean, we blame God because children suffer, animals suffer, we lose someone, children are hungry. The poor are without a home. But I know this word says that he has compassion on all he has made. The next verse that I just love is Philippians 4:8, and it reminds me about my thought life and where it needs to be. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. My favorite part of that verse is whatever is pure, whatever is lovely. And I've used that to teach my daughter over the years. When she was a toddler, I would tell her, whenever she would see something, I would say, well, that's not pure and lovely, is it? We need to think about things that are pure and lovely. They are from the Lord. They are sweet. They are not tainted with the troubles of this world, with immorality. We should be thinking about whatever is pure and lovely. This is one that helps me a lot because I struggle here. I struggle with thinking about past hurts, imaginary conversations maybe with people that have hurt me. I use this one to combat if I just have an impure thought. And sometimes, honestly, to be very honest with you, impure thoughts just attack me. And it's not even because I'm thinking about anything. It's just I'll have some random thought come into my mind and I want it to go away. I'll say this one out loud. It's Psalm 19:14. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. You know, sometimes it feels like we can't control our thought life, but we are told in the Word to control our thoughts. And, you know, sometimes I just want to bang my head and have it fall out because I want it to go away. I don't want it. What's the best way to get it out? With the sword of the Spirit. The enemy is the one dropping impure thoughts into your mind, or hateful thoughts. Might not be impure, hateful. Unforgiving thoughts, scary thoughts, fearful thoughts, all those are dropped in your mind from the enemy. Well, what's the best way to get them out? Not under our own power and our own control. Use the sword of the Spirit. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. I love this one because it is written cursive handwriting. And she wrote this card for me a couple years ago when we sat down to do scripture together. And she just thought this was a beautiful one and she wanted to write it down and memorize it. It's Acts 7:49 and 7:50. It says, "Heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. What kind of house will you build for me? Says the Lord. Has not my hand made all these things?" Just reminds me of how big our God is and how he doesn't need us, but he wants us. And the earth is his footstool. That tells me that he is over the earth and watching me and watching my family and has given me everything. This one is one I know you all know. And it's one we can use at any time whenever we feel like we are not enough, when we feel like we can't do something, when we're afraid. And it's Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. this one so much because it's one I can keep in my back pocket, so to speak. I know it. Most people do know this one. Time you just need to say a scripture out loud for teaching, correcting, rebuking, or training in righteousness. This is one you know, and it's Genesis 1:1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. This is one that I absolutely love for remembering to be overflowing with thankfulness, because there is nothing that my God can't do. There is nothing that He won't give me. I love this one because it just absolutely reminds me of the miracle that I have in having my daughter. It's a long, long story for some other day, but she's a rainbow baby. That means she came after infant loss. And He is the God that is able to give immeasurably more. And it's Ephesians 3:20. Now to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to His power that is at work within us. I love that one. He is the God who will do it. He will do it. And He can do so much more than we can ever ask or imagine. So do not be afraid to pray big prayers. Don't be afraid. You are not asking too much, but you ask in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And here's the last one. And again, I love this one. I've loved it for so long because of the miracle that God did in my life by giving me my daughter after my son died. And then I also had a miscarriage after that. I had two infant deaths in 1 year, and I was ready to give up and die. But Romans 8:28 tells me that, and we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love Him, who have been called according to His purpose. And I love this one because it reminds me that God took my pain and my heartache and my tragedy, and He turned it for good. And I have a beautiful, healthy, happy, smart, talented daughter who has God's will and God's purpose for her life written all over her. And out of my tragedy, God gave me triumph. I walked through the valley and He put me on a mountain. And that's because He makes all things, even the hardest things, work for our good when we are called according to His purpose. Thank you for watching Comfort and Joy ASMR. I hope and pray that you have a blessed week, and I hope that you take a few of these scriptures and hide them in your heart so that you might not sin against God, and that you might have the sword of the Spirit